Super Dave here with another exciting review, and today we're looking at episode 9 of action figures, playsets, and accessories that go well with MOTU Classics. And today we're looking at a set of two, well, a pack of two. I actually got two sets, so I have four of the Golden Axe Skeletons, the Golden Axe Skeleton sets. And so check this out. Look at those guys. Man, are they awesome or what? And you see the detail here of the artwork. They come with a sword and a shield. We'll be looking at all that. Look at the poses. Isn't that awesome? The dynamic poses. I mean, this set just really is awesome. They're very highly posable and articulate. And they're made by Strom Collectibles, so you know what we're in for. It's awesome. Just the varnished Golden Axe logo on the top. Nothing but legalese on the bottom. So let's break these guys open. Now, this is the set goes with, so far in the line that they've done, the Axe Battler himself. Now, that's a Mythic Legion custom painted shield that I've given him there, but I love this character. He's one of my favorites already. He's just so well made. Strom Collectibles. And of course, he came with his trusty dragon. Now, I also have done a combo review in episode 7 of playsets, action figures, and accessories that go well with MOTU of the Axe Battler and his dragon here. So you can check out that video. But look at that dragon. He's fire breathing. His mouth opens. He's highly posable as well. And this combo, they will be fighting against those skeletons. So that is just awesome. So cool. Meet me over at the review booth and let's go break these skeletons open and check them out together. All right, the first thing that we're going to do is look at these skeletons' accessories. And they come with quite a few if you count all the hands. So let's first of all check out these hands and just see how these hands measure up. First thing that we have is like a pair of just open hands, almost like reaching towards something. They look really cool. And then we have a pair of hands that are grasping, like the fingers are grasping something, and they look really cool. Check that out. The fingers are just grabbing, getting ready to grab something, or boo kind of thing. And then I really love these. Then we have a pair of pointer finger hands. Look at that. They are pointing, and that is just really scary and cool for skeletons to point at you, right? So there you go. You got a third set. And then for our fourth set, you have your weapon-holding fists. That's right. They can hold those swords with these. You can see the hole in there, and they're closed up. And then the ones that they come equipped with, we'll take a look at one of them's fists here. They come with a closed fist. And so very cool, like ready to punch right there. And so that is just really cool. And so there you have it. You have all of their hands that they come with. Man, I'm impressed with these guys. They are just really amazing. The next thing we're going to take a look at is their shields. And check that out. There's like a weathering to it, if you can see that. There's a weathering to it. It's like they're scarred and beat up. They're not perfect. You can kind of see it there. I'll try to work with the contrast there. There you go. See how that, isn't that something, how the weathering look. And then, of course, they have the place for their arm to go through and a handle to hold on. That is just so cool. So they both come, of course, with a shield. So they get two of them. Very neat. So this is like an army builder set, but boy, wouldn't it be expensive to have an army builder set of these. And then you have this really nice sword. Check that sword out. Isn't that neat? It has that silver blade, the sharpening edge of that blade, just a plain and simple handle with black hilt there, and the cross, and the cross part there, and the butt of the sword. But that is just a really nice looking sword, all and all, and again, there's two of them. Shing! All right, so that is their accessories. Now let's take a look at their articulation. Shing! All right, looking at the skeleton's articulation, his head really doesn't go up very far. It kind of hits the back of his spine there, the skull, but he's able to go all the way down. He's able to go all the way down and touch his chest there, or his rib cage. He gets excellent pivot. I mean, man, the articulation on these guys are just phenomenal. He can go back and forth, of course, and so he's able to get tons of range of motion to be able to do. And of course, don't forget, I can speak. He has the opening jaw there, so he can definitely get some things going on. Forgot to mention too, they come with a little styrofoam thing in the rib cage to help protect that rib cage, because that's open back there, so you could stuff him with a heart and lungs, whatever you have. But there you have his head and his torso area there with his ribs. But then let's take a look at his arms here. Of course, they can go all the way around, and he's got some good shoulder joints that go, you know, almost, say almost 90 degrees. You might could actually turn this around and get better. Yeah, so you can go up with it better there if you turn it around. And then he's got swivel at the shoulders there. No bicep swivel, because he really doesn't have a bicep.
Hey, who don't have a bicep? Watch this.
Get single jointed elbows. And he gets bend and swivel at the wrist.
Check out those guns. Oh yeah.
So he's definitely got some articulation going on. So that's as far as his elbow will go. Better 90 degrees, a little better 90 degrees. And then of course swivel and hinge, and you can manipulate that ball socket in there to, you know, make that bend. You can also maneuver it so that you could bend it from left to right and up and down as well if you wanted to. So, you know, like other Storm collectibles do. Go ahead and move his arms out of the way here so that we can take a look at the rest of his articulation. Let's go on down to his spine back here. This is kind of like an ab crunch. He can bend forward like so, but he can't bend back with that one. That one does not bend back. But then he has one right here in his upper pelvis area where he can bend forward and he can bend back, way back. So that's a good amount right there, I think. Looks pretty good, doesn't it? And you can also, again, manipulate that so that you can get some side-to-side motion like that. You go side-to-side. So you're going to be able to maneuver those and just get a lot of range of motion. Looking at his legs, he's able to do full splits. Check that out. And that is impressive. Right here at this hip joint, if you'll notice, it shifts up and down and forward and back. So you get a lot of range of motion there as well. And you even have thigh rotation separately, just a little bit there. He has single jointed knees, but that gets a good range of motion, and he's able to do full tiptoes there, go up pretty good amount too. He gets excellent rockers and even a toe hinge. Isn't that amazing? So I'm telling you what, these skeletons can do just about anything. They've got more articulation than some of the full-size, full-bodied, you know, organs and all action figures. But they are kind of fragile. I mean, I've had more fragile figures, but just because they're thin and, you know, in scale, the plastic, you know, you feel like they're fragile, but Storm Collectibles does a pretty good job at giving you some figures that are fairly well made, and this is no exception. I forgot to mention one accessory, if you want to count it an accessory, and that is this little poster that he comes with. select player, and then it has the digital figures there that you could select from the game Axe, Golden Axe. So that is one accessory. But let's go ahead and reveal our backdrop here. All right, before we leave the articulation, I want us to check the test to see if he can position center of balance on one foot, kind of like a karate chop action. I've seen others do this, and it kind of gives you an idea of just how much the center of balance is for a figure. There's quite a few things you can do to get to achieve that if the figure will do it. I believe he will. Yes, he will. He passes that test. He certainly does. He passes that test. There we go. Look at that. Hitting on the table doesn't knock it over very easily, so he can pass that test. And so let's do one more thing. Let's go ahead and measure him up and just see how tall our skeleton is. So to measure in our skeleton figure, he comes up to exactly 7 inches tall. So this certainly will go with your 7-inch and 6-inch scale figures, that 1/12 scale. All right, so taking a closer look, we've already switched out this hand for the open hand. And one thing I will mention, as you can see in the skeleton that's coming around in the back, there is two shields, and one of them with the logo facing up has the, as you can see back there, has the gear on one side, and then the other one has the straps and gear on the opposite side. That way you can put a shield in the skeleton's left hand in one and the right hand in the other. Otherwise this would have had to spin so that the logo wouldn't be upside down, if that makes any sense. So you're able to put this one in his right hand, going through that strap, as you can see that here. So just getting it all the way through, and then kind of bending those fingers back a little bit, then get the thumb out. You just have to kind of maneuver it just right, and then let it just kind of wrap around. It's a real gummy plastic, so it's not going to be a tight fit. But there, he's got it. He's got his shield. He's got his shield. All right, so on this hand here, let's go ahead and pop this hand off. It's as easy as that. You see, it's got that little tab going on there. And then I've got the other hand right here handy for his sword, the other grabbing hand, or a holding hand, if you want to call it that. And then you're able to slip his sword right into that grabbing, holding hand there. And there you have it. And as you can see in the background, there's what he'll look like once you get it completed. So you've got one holding that shield in the left hand, and you're going to have one holding that shield in the right hand, so that you can have one going both ways. So that is really cool. And there they are. So cool. They just look dynamic. Check them out. With all those in the background with them here, they're just looking really awesome. Go ahead and like, subscribe, share, comment, please, if you'd like, and let us know, because these are awesome. And these will go with so many different collections. You can do a army builder, set builder. Thank you for joining us for this review of these awesome characters. Having some fun with Super Dave here today. God bless you, and we'll see you next time.